So whenever I know there's a house you really like, you always do this thing, Elizabeth, where you're like, oh. So when I saw this house, I immediately could picture Elizabeth going, oh, am I right?
You know, you guys can make fun of me all you want.
Stop making fun. It's really cute.
I know.
So we're talking about the Fuller Reid House.
Yeah. Which is in Slingerlands, New York, which is outside of Albany.
I love this house, though. And I know I say I love all the houses.
Because you do.
I'm just a big old house lover. What can I say? But this house, I've never seen anything like the woodwork that is in this house. And the woodwork is so beautiful. It almost becomes, like, it's creamy, it's velvety, it's like, I was looking at this house and it made me hungry. Mm-hmm. Like, I was like, this looks so delicious.
Hungry for what, Kim?
I don't know. I like, probably marshmallows or like a campfire or just like,
yes,
steak. I don't know, just like the wood made me so hungry. It was so, and apparently a bear, but it's really beautiful. I'm so into this house and the woodwork in it.
Speaking of food, I want to talk about the kitchen in this house for a minute. You know, this is like an authentic old farmhouse kitchen. Older kitchens were not cohesive in the sense that kitchens are now. You walk into a house now and all the cabinets match.
Yeah.
And everything is kind of perfect. And it's different from the rest of the historical house in that way. Mm-hmm. This kitchen looks like other old kitchens because it's a bunch of piecemeal pieces that kind of all fit together perfectly.
Yeah.
Mm. And make the space feel very organic.
And I love the open cabinets, right? The storage areas that are open so you can see all. I mean, A, it's practical because everything's really right there at your immediate reach, but you get to see some of these really lovely utensils and items that are part of your kitchen, and you love them, they have a design, and it all just enhances the space.
Yeah, exactly. And I mean, I think it's amazing how this house too was like, it's clearly been staged for the photos, but they staged it perfectly. It's like yes, that's my taste. I think everybody would look at this house and say, I could live there. It doesn't feel too much like someone else's house.
Yeah.
It just works so well with the house itself.
It goes to show how important staging really is to helping people see themselves in a space. And there's always that fine balance, right? Because it can certainly go too far and you're just totally turned off because it feels too specific of something that you don't identify with. But then at the same time, of course, there's value as well to the whole blank slate, empty room, you know, total options in your head as to what that could be. But yeah, I feel like the Fuller Reid House really has hit it right on the mark because it's enough for me to see, oh my gosh, yes, that is how this space could be lived in and this is how I could orient it. And you know, and then you just layer on your own little items and your tchotchkes and your personality, right? So I totally agree with you.
Right, and did you guys happen to notice the width of the floorboards in the bedrooms of this house?
It's ridiculous.
Well, you walk around with a tape measure in your pocket, so I'm gonna guess that that's the first thing you saw. So no surprise there, right? Yeah. It's really amazing how much personality and just how much a room can be held together by what's happening with whatever your floor scenario
is. With the materials.
Yeah, with the materials
that make up the house.
You know, it's not like you walk into this house and the ceiling is the showstopper or the amazing staircase.
The ceiling is pretty amazing too.
But that's what I'm saying. Yeah. It's like every piece is amazing. And so the whole cohesive house just feels like it just all works together.
You want to live in this house.
If you want to live in this house, I'm going to tell you who you can call. Sarah Hislop at Sothebys.
Writing it down.
Select.
Writing it down.
Who has given us this house and made all of our wildest old house dreams come true.
So I'm pretty sure that this is Kim's official 2 weeks notice because she's moving upstate, buying a house.
I'm moving upstate. I'm selling all my belongings so I can afford a down payment on this house. I will live in an empty house with a bunch of wood around it, but I will be so happy.
Yeah, exactly.
And a lifetime supply of marshmallows.
Yes, of course.
Great.
We've come Fuller Reid Circle.
Oh, yeah!
you got that, right?